he was so strange and so great, and so, you know, the way he sung and the whole styling of his, I mean, he's not going to be imitated. I mean, no one gets together and does, you know, they might try to do a cover of Gene Genie, but, you know, they're not going to do Moon Age Daydream. But I never thought of him as dying. And I always thought, oh, well, I'll die first, you know, so I don't have to worry about it. So it was kind of shocking, you know, even though I had heard that he was sick about a year ago. But they took a picture of him on his birthday. The guy looks better than I do now, and he's dead, you know? And that was 2 days before he died, or a day before he died, you know? Or I think they took a picture of him the day before he died. He looks fantastic, you know? I mean, this guy, you know, he had really good genes. This is 45 years old now, David Bowie stuff. But whenever I put him on, he still sounds shockingly new. Shockingly, shockingly new. And there's kind of a moment where Alice Cooper, David Bowie, and Elton John kind of put performance back into rock. Because you got to remember that before Alice Cooper, David Bowie, or Elton John, there were jam bands. And they just got up there and they jammed. They had long hair in front of their eyes and stuff. You know, with these guys, they kind of put theater back into rock and roll, you know, with Alice and Bowie. I thank God they did, because I think rock and roll would have just dissolved under the mediocrity of jam bands.